thought I said I'd do the milking this morning.
I know, but you were sleeping so soundly.
I wanted you to have a rest.
I've had plenty of rest. And anyway, I reckon you needed it more than me.
Well, maybe. I don't even remember the alarm going off.
Well, there you go then. It's fine. I'm feeling a lot better this morning.
Good, but I'm still going to ask Eddie to do some extra shifts. He won't mind.
Okay, all right. If it makes you happy.
It does. Well, I better go and check on the sheep.
Sure.
And the tyres from the assault course still need moving back to the clamp. When are Elizabeth and the twins meant to be over?
Around 12, she said.
Okay. Well, I'll see you then.
Okay. What?
Nothing. I'm allowed to smile at my wife, aren't I?
Yeah.
I'm just thinking about how amazing you are.
David.
That's okay, isn't it?
Of course it's okay. Thank you.
What for?
Just for being you.
Dope.
Now go on, there's plenty to do.
Yeah.
The work doesn't stop just because we're having a baby.
Hey, you. Made you a cup of tea.
Cheers.
Ooh, how's that jaw? Does it hurt to shave?
No, it's fine.
Oh, let me see.
Helen, your prodding isn't going to help, is it?
All right, sorry. Rob?
What?
Don't be like that.
Well, I know what you're going to say.
No, you don't.
I do. You're going to start interrogating me all over again.
I just want to know why Ian hit you.
And I told you. I can see you in the mirror, by the way.
Look, if Ian took what you said the wrong way...
It was just a bit of banter. I was trying to encourage him.
Okay,
but... You know, leave no man behind. He wasn't going to get round the course on his own.
Well, you must have said something else.
You don't believe me?
I've just never known Ian to do anything like this.
Then maybe you don't know Ian as well as you thought, hmm?
I should talk to him. I could explain you didn't mean.
Helen, no.
But you're going to Tom's stag do on Wednesday. You're spending the whole night in Birmingham. You're staying at the same hotel.
Only because you want me to.
Yes, so Ian's going to be there too. We need to patch things up somehow.
Helen.
Let me just talk to him.
No. Aren't you listening? I tried to make amends. I tried to speak to him.
Did you?
Yes.
When?
You were there in the pub.
You wouldn't tell me what you actually said to each other, though.
No, because he wasn't having any of it. Now, if Ian wants to come to me and apologise, then that's different.
Rob.
But I'm getting pretty sick of always being the one doing the legwork. First it was Kirsty, then your parents.
Okay, okay.
Tom, now Ian.
I know.
I've gone through hell and high water trying to ingratiate myself with your friends and family. Remember, I didn't start this, Helen. Ian's the one who punched me.
Yes, all right.
That'd be nice if you'd actually stand up for me for once.
There you are, Jill. Elizabeth's here.
Oh, right. I've almost finished.
Oh, you needn't have done this, you know. I could have managed.
Don't be daft.
Here, pass me a pillow slip.
You know, Ben really could be doing things like changing his own bed by now.
I know.
We'll have even less time in a few months. He's not going to be the baby of the family anymore.
Quite literally.
So he's going to have to get used to pitching in.
Yeah, well, like you say, he's got a while yet. Let him enjoy it.
Mm. Have you thought about when you're going to tell them?
The kids? No. Oh, Mum, for that matter.
There's no rush, I suppose. Although I'm sure she'll be thrilled.
And the rest. I know what she's like. She'll think she's helping. But, well... I just need to get things straight in my own head first.
Of course.
There's so much to consider. Bedrooms, for a start. We're packed to the gunnels. And Pitt will be back from a placement by the time the baby's here.
Indeed.
I suppose she'll have to move into Rickyard. Although it'll be a shame to lose the income from the rent.
Oh, yes.
I'm sure she'd be happy with that.
And so you're thinking of putting the cot in Pip's room?
Seems like the simplest solution, doesn't it?
Yes, I see.
Oh, Lily!
Hey.
Hello, sweetheart.
What are you doing there?
We were just about to come downstairs.
I wanted to see Bradley Wiggins' autograph. Ben said I could fetch it.
Right. Well, I'm not sure where it is. It might be on his desk.
Oh, thanks.
I should check on the joint.
Yeah, and I need to put these dirty bedclothes on to wash.
We'll leave you to it, Lily.
You can have the room to yourself.
I'm really sorry, Ian. I didn't mean to spoil your lie-in.
No, it's all right.
I would come back later, but...
No, look, I wasn't asleep. Just being lazy. I've still got cramps in my legs from Friday.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and I was on my feet at the pass all last night.
I take it Adam's working?
Yeah. Do you want a tea or a coffee? Oh,
not bothered. Whatever you're making.
Hey, espresso it is, then.
Oh, thanks.
Well, come on, then. Turn me off a strip, or has Rob sent you over to make the piece?
No, of course not, Ian. Rob doesn't even know I'm here. He thinks I've popped over to see Mum and Dad.
Right.
And I haven't come to have a go at you either. I just want to know what happened. I've tried talking to Rob, and he just says it was a bit of banter that got out of hand.
That what he said?
So there is more to it, then?
No. Sounds about right.
Oh, come on, Ian, there's got to be. You're not the sort of guy who goes around hitting people. I'd rather you were just honest.
What do you want me to say, Helen?
The truth. That's all. Must have taken a lot to make you see red like that. So then tell me, what did Rob do to provoke you?
I know, I'm sorry, I know I'm running late.
No, don't worry. The children are all playing computer games.
Oh, right.
And lunch won't be for another half an hour.
Oh.
So, who are we here?
Well, she's got a weepy eye. I need to put in some drops.
Oh. Well, as I say, you've still got a while before we eat.
I know, Mum. Half an hour?
David. I've been thinking, it might be time for me to move home.
I'm sorry? Home?
Yes. I was talking to Ruth earlier, and the two of you could probably do with me out of your hair.
What are you talking about?
Well, there certainly won't be enough room when the baby comes.
Mum?
And I've been feeling so much more confident since I had my op. There's really no reason to carry on imposing myself.
Oh, Mum. The last thing you're doing is imposing. For goodness sake, we need you now more than ever.
Really?
Of course we do. Look, I admit, when the baby does come, it is going to be a bit of a squeeze, but that's down the line.
I know.
And in the meantime, I want Ruth to be able to take things easy. Unless you really want to go home, that is.
No.
Good. Because having you with us, it was a godsend even before we knew Ruth was pregnant.
Well, just as long as I'm being useful.
Honestly. We're about to sit down to a delicious Sunday roast that you cooked. Why would you think that you weren't?
I am going to have to go home at some point. I could stay a bit longer. Mm. At least until Ruth's feeling less tired.
Yeah.
Hello, Lily.
Hi.
I thought you were playing games with the boys.
I was. It was so boring. All they want to do is shoot zombies.
Right, well, I'd better deal with this little one. You could help me if you like, Lily.
No.
You sure?
Yeah, thanks though.
Okay. Well, I'll see you in a bit then.
Yes, and I need to put the vegetables on.
Gran?
Yes?
What were you talking about with Auntie Ruth?
When was this?
Earlier, up in Ben's room.
Nothing really.
You were saying something about Pip.
Yes. Just that she'll need her room back when she comes back from Yorkshire.
Right.
She won't want me sleeping in there, will she? That's all.
Nothing else?
No. Now tell me, it's Mothering Sunday next week, isn't it? Have you got anything planned?
Just a card.
Well, I've had an idea. I was going to make Auntie Ruth a simnel cake. Why don't we make one for your mum, too?
Oh, come on. He was only joking.
Was he?
Yes. We're not even sure we want the lodge when I do inherit, which hopefully won't be for ages. Might have bought our own house by then. Rob thinks we should rent it out.
Oh, right, so he has discussed it with you?
He thinks it'll be a good way of saving money for Henry.
Right.
You see? He only meant it as a bit of fun. Rob's that kind of bloke.
He doesn't realise some people are more sensitive.
Oh, you think I'm being sensitive?
Wrong word.
Helen, that's got nothing to do with being sensitive.
Then what is it to do with Ian? Is it that you just don't like him? I mean, you've got on well before. I mean, I thought we had a great time the other night when you came over for dinner.
Look, I just find him...
What?
I mean, you said it. All right, he's that kind of bloke. He can be very domineering.
Domineering?
Yeah, come on, you must see it.
Well, not particularly. When?
Well, you want me to give you examples?
I mean, I suppose Rob is very sure of himself. Maybe that comes across as arrogance.
Helen!
But he's not like that at all.
Okay, so
look,
what about...
Ian. He's the most caring, generous, thoughtful man I've ever met. Breaks my heart when people don't seem to see that.
Fine, that's all right. Maybe I'm misinterpreting him.
I think you are.
Well, that's what Adam tells me anyway.
Really?
Yeah, he thinks it's a public school thing.
Well, yeah, maybe it is. I mean, Adam would know. So, do you think you can make it up with him? Rob says he's happy to forget about it.
Does he? Right.
And then there's Tom Stagnite. You are still going, aren't you? Ian, you have to.
No, it's just tricky. But... I could do with an early start on Thursday.
Hold on. Rob, hi.
Where are you?
I'm still at the farm, chatting with Mum.
Oh, so when do you think you'll be home?
Not sure. Soon, I suppose. Why? There's nothing wrong, is there?
No. I was just wondering when to start lunch. Henry's getting hungry.
Oh, right. Well, I won't be long.
10 minutes?
Yep. Something like that.
Oh, fine. Say hi to your mum for me.
Will do. Bye. I'm going to have to go.
Right.
But honestly, Ian, I promise there won't be an issue if you go on the stag do. Rob wants to put this behind him.
So you said.
And Tom will be so disappointed if you're not there. Please, don't let a silly squabble spoil it for him.
Helen, I don't know if...
Or for me. Please say you'll go.
But how's that even possible, Alistair? They had their pre-movement test.
No, I know.
I checked the paperwork before I bought them.
Of course you did, Tony.
So how can this have happened?
Well, the tests aren't always 100% reliable.
Oh, I don't believe
Look,
it.
There's nothing definite yet.
There must be some kind of mistake.
And we'll see. In the meantime, though...
They're going to slap restrictions on me, I suppose.
I'm sorry, Tony.
Oh, great. Well, this is a fantastic start.
Afternoon.
Oh, all right, Tom.
How's it going? What?
Oh, you tell him I can't bear to.
Dad?
The cow that died last week. The post-mortem's shown up. Lesions on the lymph nodes.
Lesions?
Yeah.
Oh!
It looks like early signs of TB.
Helen, show me!
No!
Oh, what's in the bag? It better not be sashes.
It's a secret.
Or devil horns, or anything in the shape of a man's you-know-what.
Would I?
Well, it's my hen night.
Well, you're just going to have to wait till Thursday. Now, I'm going to hide this somewhere in the stockroom where you won't be able to find it.
So all you'll tell me is that I need to dress up.
Yep, that's right.
Well, is that swanky-doo dressed up, or clubbing, short skirt and high heels dressed up?
Well... I'm going to wear my black halter neck.
Ah, so, swanky-do dressed up.
Kirsty, you're not getting any more clues out of me.
Oh.
If I were you, I'd be more worried for Tom.
Why? What have you heard?
Oh, nothing. But after what happened between Rob and Ian...
Oh, right, yeah.
I went over and had a chat with him yesterday.
Well, it was all anyone could talk about in the pub. Punch up in front of a knight of the realm.
Oh, don't. I've managed to persuade Ian to go on the stag night now. Although I'm wondering if that was such a good idea.
Oh, you know what guys are like. They flare up and then a couple of pints and it's all right as rain.
God, I hope so.
It'll be fine. Listen, now that you're here, do you mind if I take a break? I need to speak to the bank about our mortgage offer.
Oh, yeah, go ahead.
I'll try not to be long.
Yeah, take as long as you need. Just no peeking.
Look, let's just keep our fingers crossed, hey? We're not certain it's TB, are we, Alistair?
Well...
You just said it might be something else.
Possibly. It could be viral pneumonia.
There you are.
It still doesn't stop the herd from being put under restriction.
Or rule out an underlying case of TB.
OK, but we don't know, do we?
And we won't until the cultures have been done.
How long's that going to take?
6 to 8 weeks.
Meanwhile, I'm left wondering how many more cows are infected. how many more I'm going to lose.
I know, Dad, but listen...
I'd better answer that. It's probably animal health ringing to tell me my fate.
Dad!
What a shame. I really wasn't expecting TB, and I see it so often.
So, what's the likelihood of it being confirmed?
Tom, honestly...
I know, you can't say.
I really can't. But if it is confirmed, it's incredibly unlucky. And for it to happen just as Tony was beginning this new venture.
Yeah, well, I suppose that's the risk you take bringing new animals onto the farm.
Still, the movement restrictions shouldn't affect him too badly. I mean, he's not intending to sell the cows, is he?
Nope.
So, really, it's no more than a nuisance, for the time being, anyway.
Well, let's hope.
Oh, I best get on. Adam's expecting me.
Sure.
His deer are due for their vaccinations.
Alistair, before you go, I was just wondering, what risk do you think there is to the pigs?
The pigs? Well, there shouldn't be any.
Oh, good.
Just as long as they haven't had direct contact with the cows. Tom, there hasn't been, has there?
Thanks. And if you can't find any here, Rissa, we should have some more later this week. Sorry, Kirsty.
No.
So, the bank have agreed?
Mm. The offer's in the post.
Oh, that's amazing! Well, aren't you pleased?
I'm a bit scared. I mean, when you actually start saying the figures out loud.
Oh, no, I know.
Plus, it's going to be a bit tight. They say they can only guarantee the offer for 6 months, which is when the house is supposed to be finished.
Oh, right.
So if there are any delays to the building work, and if rates have gone up by then...
Oh, I see.
Listen to me. I'm already turning into one of those people who's always going on about interest rates and house prices.
Well, it's called being a grown-up. It's why it's so exciting.
Yeah, I suppose.
Oh, come on, give Tom a call. Tell him the good news.
Yes, I realise... I mean, if TB is confirmed, 2 consecutive clear skin tests over 60 days. Right, I see. No, I understand. I'll wait to hear from you then.
Well, that's just perfect.
Yeah, bye.
I hope you're pleased with yourself.
Tom?
Now my pigs are going to be put under restriction too.
The pigs? What are you...
What did I tell you, Dad?
Tom! Just calm down. What are you talking about? What restrictions?
Because they broke out.
You mean the cows?
Through a shoddy fence that you got them put up.
Look.
And now, because they got into the field with my pigs, it's likely I'm going to have restrictions placed on me too.
No, Tom, that can't be right.
Not now.
I've just spoken to Animal Health. They didn't even ask about the pigs.
No, but Alistair thinks I should tell them. How could you be so stupid? You've already stifled my expansion plans by buying in that damn herd.
I couldn't.
And now this.
Tom, I did everything by the book.
Except to tell me.
I spoke to the vet. I checked.
Or Helen.
No, but...
You just secretly went ahead. Sprung the cows on us without even considering how we were set up for them.
Don't be ridiculous. This farm's had cows on it for years.
And now it's going to cost us all money.
What money? How's it costing you anything?
What if that cow does have TB? What if it's been passed on and my pigs have to be slaughtered, eh? It's all right for you.
Oh, I see.
You get paid compensation. If I lose any pigs, I don't get a penny.
You've changed your tune. Half an hour ago, you were telling me we didn't even have TB.
I was trying to be reassuring. Although, who knows why I bothered. Not when you've been so utterly selfish.
Yes, well, it's easy to be reassuring when you're not the one who's affected. Look... As far as anyone could tell, those cows were perfectly healthy. What else was I meant to do? It's unfortunate, but that's nature.
You could have started by not buying the cows. You could have started by not trying
Tom,
to make some idiotic
Tom.
Point about
Listen
how you're still
yourself.
The big man.
I am allowed to make my own decisions.
Then we wouldn't be in this mess.
Yeah, this is my farm as well. You don't get to have it all your own way.
For God's sake, Dad, this isn't about whose farm it is. It's our farm, all of us.
Is it now?
Yes, in it together.
Right, I'll remember that.
But when you bought that herd, you proved it's got nothing to do with your principles or missing the cows.
Really?
You just didn't give a damn about anyone else.
Have you finished?
Yes.
Good. Because this isn't my fault, Tom. I've already got one dead cow. I'm taking the brunt of it. And before you start making any more accusations about how selfish I am, maybe you should have a long, hard look at yourself.
Tom,
So what I like most is how open plan it is.
Mm.
In the show home, we had a big corner sofa. Oh, it was so comfy.
So which plot is yours?
That one there. Oh, and I wanted to show you... yeah, these are the kitchen cabinets we can choose from. I think I like the shaker in white.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, and I love those tiles.
Oh, Kirsty, so many decisions.
I know. Oh, hi, Tom.
Hi.
Hi.
Oh, hi, Helen.
Congratulations. I'm having a look at the plans for your new house.
Did you get my message?
Message?
About the mortgage offer.
Oh, yes. Sorry. I've not been having a great day. I was right, by the way.
About what?
Dad's cows. He might have TB in the herd.
Oh, no.
And because they've been in contact with my pigs, they might be infected too.
Oh, no. You're joking.
I wish I was. Look, I need to ring Alistair.
Sure, but...
I could really do with a beer.
Oh, well, there should be some in the fridge.
Thanks.
TB. Can't believe it.
Me neither. I was wondering why he hadn't returned my call.
Oh, you can just imagine how things are between him and Dad.
Oh,
Lord.
Well, that's soured the mood, hasn't it?
Honestly, those cows! As if they haven't caused enough trouble already.
Sorry, Tom. I've been meaning to ring back.
Don't worry.
But Adam had a close shave with one of the deer. She got a bit feisty going into the crush. Clipped his head on the frame.
Oh, no. Is he all right?
Yeah, he's fine. Could have been worse, though.
I bet.
So, anyway, have you been in touch with Animal Health?
No, not yet.
I suppose you've been busy.
Actually, Alistair, I was kind of curious what would happen if I didn't. I mean, the cows weren't in the field for long, and the pigs didn't really get in amongst them.
Ah, maybe not.
So the chances of them transferring an infection...
Look, Tom, even if you do inform Animal Health, there's still no obligation to have the pigs tested.
No, I know.
It's not like with cattle.
They might still stop me moving them, though.
Yeah, but in practice, all that means is you'd have to apply for a licence every time you send some to slaughter.
Well, exactly.
And imagine if you were Neil and were breeding wieners to sell on.
No, I know.
In fact, you'd probably still be allowed to buy wieners in. Maybe a few breeding sows, you know, the odd boar.
Oh, great.
All under licence, of course. And as long as the numbers weren't too large.
Good job Dad's put the kibosh on that, then. And I wouldn't have to have the pigs tested.
No. Although if you didn't, the carcasses would be thoroughly inspected at the abattoir. It's not that onerous.
Oh, I still don't know. It seems like a lot of hassle when I could be under restrictions for years. Who knows how long this could drag on for? If I make that call...
Look, the only advice I can give you, Tom, is to discuss it with Animal Health. That's my professional and my personal opinion. But it's entirely up to you.
Yeah.
Tom, is everything okay?
I'd better go, Alistair. Thanks, anyway.
Okay, sure.
I'll see you around.
What did he say?
Nothing much. He agrees the chance of the pigs contracting TB is very small.
Really? Oh, well, that's good news.
Yeah.
See, there's no need to worry. Especially not when there's so much else to be excited about. Just try not to think about it. Mm. Come on.
Kirsty.
Come back through to the lounge. I need to tell you about my conversation with the bank.
Look.
And there's the wedding list. There's a couple more things I wanted to add.
Okay.
Oh, and Alice has been in touch. She's had some thoughts about the boxes for the wedding favours.
Actually, I think I might go and have a bath instead.
Oh. So you don't want to?
Can't we discuss it later?
Sure.
I'm sorry. I just need some time to myself.
No, I understand.
Wash the day away. I reckon I've had about as much of it as I can take.
So, what exactly did the doctor say?
Well, don't get me wrong, she was lovely. But when she started running through the potential problems, high blood pressure, preeclampsia... all the different conditions they screen for.
Well, I'm sure she was just, you know, making you aware.
No, I know.
Doesn't mean that any of it's going to happen to you.
No, I know, David. But it doesn't change the fact that I'm a lot older now either. Time does take its toll.
You're not having second thoughts?
No.
Ruth?
No, of course not. Honestly, David.
Good. Because if you're feeling old, imagine how I feel.
You're all right. You've done your job.
Ha! Huh. Whoa!
And I'm not having second thoughts. It just made me realise this pregnancy could be very different from the others.
Well, one step at a time, eh?
Yeah.
Look, I need to go. Someone's here.
Sure, I'll be back home in a few minutes anyway.
Okay. Love you.
Love you too.
Hello, Ruth.
Hi, Peggy. How are you?
Oh, not too bad. I could do without these grey skies, but apart from that...
No, I know what you mean.
Alan came over this morning. Showed me some pictures of stained glass windows.
Oh, for St. Stephen's.
Well, examples of artists they're considering. Beautiful work. It was nice to be reminded that the sun does come out occasionally.
I bet.
Oh, but what's been happening with you? Haven't seen you for a while.
You
keeping well?
Fine. I'm just on my way back from town. Sorry to hear about Tony's cows, by the way.
Tony's cows?
Yeah, such a shame.
I'm sorry, I don't think I've...
Oh, haven't you heard?
No.
Oh, right.
Why? What's happened?
Well, they might have TB. One of them died last week, and when the results came back from the post-mortem... Well...
TB?
I just assumed you must know.
No. Nobody said anything to me. When was this?
Yesterday. At least I think so. Tony rang David in a bit of a state last night.
I see.
Oh, just a sec.
But surely Tony must have done checks. They can't have had TB when he bought them. It was only a few weeks ago.
What?
Ruth, something wrong?
No, it's just a message from Pip. Sorry, I'd better go. I need to get home.
Yes, of course.
It was lovely to see you, though.
You too. Actually, Ruth, as you're driving, would you mind dropping me off at Bridge Farm?
That's it. Forward a bit more. Yep, you're good. You're over the hopper. Sorry about that, Tony.
No, no.
I tell you, this new guy doesn't hang about.
You still reckon you'll be finished tomorrow, then?
Yep. Then the potato planter is all yours.
Oh, that's one good thing at least.
So, where are you at? Skin test for the entire herd?
No, well, not yet anyway. There's not much point, is there? They've only just had their pre-movement test.
Oh, yeah, of course.
And TB didn't show up then.
Right.
Makes you wonder what's the point of doing them at all.
Well, I suppose they pick up the majority of cases.
Well, anyway, Animal Health say that if the cultures come back positive, we'll have to test the cows then.
And in the meantime, you're left waiting.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Tony. It's such a horrible feeling. Never knowing how long it's going to drag on for. Or how many animals you're going to lose.
At the moment, I'm just praying that won't happen.
Yeah, of course. No, sorry. Sorry, I shouldn't be so pessimistic.
Well, no, you've been through it.
It's just incredibly bad luck. Especially knowing how much you wanted those cows.
It's not just the cows, though, is it? There's Tom's pigs as well.
Yeah.
As far as I know, he hasn't spoken to Animal Health yet.
Hasn't he? Right.
It's just one thing on top of another.
Hi, love.
Hey.
Look, I should leave you to it.
Well, if there's anything we can do.
Yeah, thanks. Afternoon, Ruth.
So this is where you are. I just dropped Peggy at your place.
Mum's at the farm?
Yeah, she asked for a lift.
Oh, okay.
Listen, Tony, I kind of let it slip about the TB. We were chatting and...
Right.
I thought she knew. Have I done the wrong thing?
No, don't worry. I better not keep her waiting.
Bye, Tony.
I'm sorry. Oh, say hi to Pat for me. Oh, dear. It wasn't a secret, was it?
No, but you know what they say. Careless talk costs lives.
Oh, me and me big mouth.
Hey, come on, let's get you inside. You can tell me all about the doctors.
Oh, David.
Hmm?
About that. We might have a problem.
What? I thought you said there wasn't anything wrong.
No, there isn't. But I just got a text from Pip. For some reason, Ben and Josh think she's pregnant.
I'm sorry, Mum. I don't have time for this now.
You can spare 5 minutes, just while you make a coffee.
I've got to go straight back out to the packing shed.
All right.
The veg from the co-op needs sorting through.
And that's fine. I only want to know how serious it is. All Ruth could tell me was that you had TB.
In one cow, possibly.
So the rest of the herd aren't infected, then? Tony?
I don't know.
So they might not be?
I said, I don't know.
Well, how did it happen? Who did you buy them from? Were they infected when you bought them? Oh, surely you should have been able to find out.
For crying out loud. Are you happy now?
Tony!
Is that why you came? To rub in how right you were?
No!
How I've messed up again. Well, congratulations. This never would have happened if I'd been a good boy and rolled over for you and Tom.
Oh, Tony, please, stop it. Of course I'm not happy.
Then why are you here, Mum?
Because...
Well?
Because I was worried about you. That's why.
But where did she get that from?
Well, we've just spoken to Ben, and he says Lily told them.
That Pip's pregnant?
Yeah.
Well, she's not, is she?
No.
So why would she think that? David?
Well, that's the thing, Elizabeth. We think that she might have overheard a conversation between Mum and Ruth. You see, it's not that there isn't going to be a new arrival.
There isn't?
Only Lily got the wrong person.
David, you're not...
Ruth's expecting.
Oh, my God. That's unbelievable.
Thank you, I think.
No, but... congratulations. I take it it wasn't planned.
No, well, not entirely, no. I'm still getting my head around it. Which is why we hadn't really wanted to make it public.
Oh.
I mean, Pip and the boys don't even know about it yet.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Oh, David.
No.
Look, I'll speak to Lily.
If we can just keep it within the family...
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
David?
I'm just on the phone.
Oh, sorry.
No, David, it's all right. I'll let you go. Oh, give my love to Ruth, though.
Yeah, I will. Bye, then.
Bye.
Was that Elizabeth?
Yeah, she sends her love. Did you manage to get through to Pip?
No, she must be busy. She's not answering her phone.
Have you left her a message?
David, I'm not going to tell Pip I'm pregnant in a voicemail.
No, I didn't mean that. Well, this isn't exactly what we intended.
None of it is. At this point, I'm just going along for the ride.
Are you all right?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
I'm fine. Just wondering what the reaction's going to be. Josh is home, by the way.
Is he? Right. Well, in that case...
Yep.
Shall we go and break the news?
Well, what about the auctioneer? Couldn't you go back to him?
No.
But surely if you bought the herd in good faith...
The letter at the market was DEFRA approved. There's no comeback.
Oh, gosh, I'm sorry.
It's just bad luck. That's what everyone keeps telling me, anyway.
Yes, I suppose so.
Although I reckon I've had my fair share. It's about time someone else had a dose. Brian, for instance.
Oh, now, Tony.
Well, he shipped 1,500 head of cattle halfway across the continent and not one of them had TB.
I know,
I buy a couple of dozen from the next county.
It's still no reason to wish it on somebody else.
It's not what I'm saying. I'm sick of it, Mum. I'm sick of everything always being uphill, of fighting Tom.
I'm sure he doesn't want that either.
He never thinks about what I might be going through, though those cows were supposed to be a fresh start.
Which is why I wish you hadn't bought them. This is just the sort of stress I knew you could do without.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, wasn't the whole point of getting rid of the dairy herd to take the pressure off you?
Yes, but
But you insisted on having these cows.
So this is my fault, then?
No.
I've brought this on myself.
That's not what I'm saying, Tony. You always mishear me.
It's what it sounds like.
But there's no point in feeling sorry for yourself. The cows are here now. They're not going anywhere.
Not now.
So you're just going to have to see it through.
Oh, don't you worry. That's precisely what I'm going to do.
Yes, hello, Tig. It's nice to see you too.
Elizabeth, hello. What are you doing here?
All right, boy.
Tig, get down. Go on, get down.
Good boy.
There was no need to bring flowers.
Oh, I wanted to do something. And they're an apology, apart from anything else.
Well, what on earth for?
On behalf of my indiscreet daughter. We've had a rather serious chat.
Oh, no, she hasn't done any harm.
Well, as long as you're sure.
No.
I've been feeling terrible.
Look, not at all. In fact, we have just told the boys.
And?
Well, after it sunk in, they actually seem quite pleased. Josh, took a while to get his head round how it was even possible.
Yeah, well, as every teenager knows, parents don't actually have sex.
No, oh. No, of course not. Anyway, Ben just got excited when he realised he might be able to swap his room with Pips.
Oh, hi, Elizabeth.
Hey, Ruth.
This is a surprise.
Well, not as big as the one you've given us. Congratulations.
Oh, thanks. Oh. Those aren't for me, are they?
Well, both of you. I was just saying to David, look, they're partly an apology.
Oh, don't be daft.
Here, let me take them from you.
I've just got off the phone to Pip.
Oh, yeah? What did she say?
Sooner me than her.
Quite right, too.
No, she says she thinks it's wonderful. She was so happy. She was squealing down the phone.
What were you expecting?
Well, I knew you were fretting.
Well, it's a big deal for all of us. I thought there might be some more shock.
Yes, but why wouldn't they all be delighted? It's the best news I've heard in ages.
Oh, Elizabeth.
No, genuinely, I couldn't be more thrilled for you.
Oh, thanks, sis.
Well, that means a lot. Tig seems excited about it, too.
Well, you're going to be on a par with Mum and Dad.
Yeah, aren't we just?
Well, it's strange the way history repeats itself. It might even be a little girl, two of each.
Maybe.
You never know.
Just as long as she doesn't take after her auntie.
Hey, you! Well, I was an angel compared to Kenton and Shula.
Well, I don't care. Whatever it is, he or she's going to have the most wonderful, loving family. And that's the most important thing, hey?
All right, listen up. No photos, no Facebook, no calling her indoors. What happens in Brum stays in Brum.
But, Rob, how are we going to take pictures of Tom lashed to a lamppost?
Don't you dare.
Oh, we're going to be much more inventive than that. Come on, let's see those phones turned off.
Hey, what happened to the gorilla suit, Roy?
Oh, it's back at the hotel.
Gorilla?
Well, I thought it was a nurse's outfit.
Oh, French maids, surely.
No, we're just going to strip him naked.
Yeah,
and go to town with the clippers. You won't do any of that, or you wouldn't be saying it.
All right, that queue's moving.
That's what he thinks.
Adam, were you listening? Well, come on then.
Uh-oh, right. Domestic already. But, right, everyone, follow Ian. I got the tickets.
Jazza, wait.
What?
Just hold on. Look, I'm not in the mood for any pranks this evening.
No, your choice, pal. Shouldn't have had a stag night.
Even so, I'm depending on you to make sure it doesn't get out of hand.
You work? Well, no work now, Tom. You can't land me with other crap jobs.
No, but you do want time off to rehearse this passion play, don't you? Something to do with a girl you're interested in?
Aye, Alicia. She measured me up for my costume.
Exactly. So, quid pro quo?
Quid pro what? Is this some fancy word for blackmail?
Look, Jazza, I've had a really rubbish week. Just keep an eye out for me, will you? Deal?
Aye, all right, Tom. I'll be your wingman.
Thanks.
So, do I still get paid for the time off?
It's not just me, then. He looks like he really clouted you.
Yeah, that was a deer, Rob.
I know.
He hit his head on the crush.
I'm only messing with you, Ian. We're all here to have a good time, aren't we? I mean, if you can't have a laugh in a comedy club, then where can you?
No.
And a vodka, please? No ice?
Listen, I might go and sit down.
Ian, can I get you anything else? A chaser? Whiskey? Tequila? What about you, Adam?
Well...
No.
No.
Oh, come on. Look, you used to play rugby, didn't you?
Well, cricket was more my thing.
So, do you remember any good drinking games? There was this one. You have to point your elbow at another member of the team and say...
G'day, Bruce.
Ah, you know it.
Of course.
Well, I reckon that's one for later.
Sounds great.
Now, which pint is Tom's?
It's any one of the lagers.
Oh, here, have a sip.
Why?
We need to make room for the vodka.
Well, I hope you know what you're letting yourself in for, Tom.
Don't you start as well.
I used to be the Byron of Borchester.
Sir. In his head, perhaps.
Yeah, and now look at me. I'm stuck drinking mineral water.
Stop whinging, will you?
If you want a bevy, Kenton, just have one.
What, and let Jolene win? Away.
It's your fault for getting up for Len.
No, we won't tell.
No. I'll know, though, won't I? And where's the satisfaction in that?
Married life, eh? Nothing to look forward to except getting one over on the missus.
Getting one what over?
Aye, that I know.
Even that gets less and less.
Yeah, all right. Yeah, no more fluffy handcuffs. Just real ones.
Oh, thanks, guys. You're making me feel a whole lot better.
We're only giving you our advice, Tom.
Yeah, this is the rest of your life we're talking about.
Right, watch your backs.
Man,
Pint of lager for you, Tom.
Cheers.
And for you, Jazza and Roy.
No,
Jazza, that pint's Tom.
So who's on
What's
tonight,
What's the difference?
Roy?
It's our lager.
I can't remember. It's on the flyer.
Just give him that glass. And a sparkling mineral water for Kenton.
With ice and lemon too? Oh, you're spoiling me.
Listen, by the way, gents, I meant to say, if you've got any stories about the groom here,
Roy.
Well, now's the time to tell me. I need it for me best man speech.
No, really, don't help him.
How many do you want?
Oh, what's the matter, Kenton? Mineral water too strong for you?
That's not water. It's gin and tonic. Hey! You know it is. So much for Lent. I've drunk alcohol now.
Bad luck, mate.
Yeah, you may as well finish it. The damage is done.
Oh, for Rob, your drink. I don't even like gin and tonic.
Cheers, Adam.
Yeah, have a lager then.
Hey, that's my pint.
Mind you don't spill it, Rob.
No, I've got it.
You don't want that, you. Have mine. I'll have the G&T.
Right. Has everyone got a glass in their hand?
Yeah.
Right. To Tom, then. Let the jokes be on him.
Yeah,
Tom.
Your face.
Tom's?
When he thought the compere was going to drag him on stage.
You didn't have to tell him I made sausages for a living.
Who are you moaning about? None of you, Tom, doing free publicity.
Yeah, I reckon he got off lightly.
So, boys, where now?
Kenton, mind yourself. How much have you had?
Well, I don't know how the rest of you boys feel, but there is a gentleman's club over there.
Ah, you spotted that, I know. Mm-hmm.
Well, actually, Rob, we were going to go to a bar. It's meant to do really good cocktails.
Cocktails?
Whereabouts?
10 minutes walk.
This is just across the road. I bet they'll do cocktails as well.
Yeah, but
what do you think, Tom?
I'm not sure. Lap dancing? It's a bit degrading, isn't it?
You mean that's what Kirsty's told you to think?
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, look, I'd never hear the last of it.
Yeah, and I'm already in trouble with the missus.
Which is why we agreed no one would find out.
Oh, look, it's Tom's decision. If he doesn't want to go...
Yes, he does.
Well...
And so do Jazza and I.
Well, it's a no from me.
Yeah, and me.
And there isn't any point asking Adam and Ian. Sorry, boys, but you're not exactly qualified. So, it's all down to you, Tom. What do you say?
Last chance to have yourself a bit of fun.
Eh? Oh, here, I'll tell you what. There's a club round the corner. They play good music. It's not far to walk. Why don't we just go there?
Yeah. Let's do that. Sorry, guys.
No, it's fine by me.
If that's what you'd honestly prefer.
So, where are we going?
This way. It's just right up Kent Street.
Oh. Ian. What do you think you're doing?
Well, I'm just using my neutrality to broker a compromise.
But it's a gay club.
Oh, yeah. So it is.
Oh, come on.
No.
Oh, Rob, now go on your feet.
No, I don't think so, Kenton.
I see you wiggle those hips of yours.
Thanks, but I'm quite happy sitting here. Now, you go and make some new friends, sir.
I think I will. Is that my shot?
Isn't it Tom's?
What's that?
No, I drank his.
Right, down the hatch. Oh. Last chance.
Bye, Kenton.
Here I go.
Woohoo! Seriously, though, you know we were only winding you up.
I know.
I mean, me and Hayley, sure, we might not be swinging from the lampshades anymore, but it's the little things. Hayley's hair on my face when she leans over with a cup of tea or flopping down on the sofa together at the end of the day.
Ah, you're really selling it, Tim Roy.
Yeah, no, I know what he means.
Yeah, you're getting a divorce.
Well, not for the lack of effort, but... Jess, she wanted things to carry on like when we were kids, you know? Old fairy tale romance. But she didn't want to be a wife.
Listen to you both try to convince yourselves.
Just because commitment to you is remembering her name the day afterwards.
That's where you're wrong. There's one lassie I'd settled in for.
Oh, yeah?
Aye, she's back in the market.
Who?
Mind your own business. But if she was with me, I'd make every day a fairy tale.
No, but listen, Tom. If you and Kirsty weren't meant for each other, you wouldn't have gone back together after all these years. Anyone can see that.
Thanks. And on that note, I'm going to find the toilet.
Oh, look, I'll come with you.
Well, good idea. Take some protection.
I'm going to fetch another round. Same again.
Cheers.
Oh, and get some more shots.
I say,
Tom can take his booze, can't he?
Huh? Oh, aye.
All those spiked drinks, he should be falling over by now. I reckon we're going to have to up the ante.
How do you mean?
He's had an easy ride so far. Now, if we can just get him drunk enough.
Ah, it won't work. He's too on the ball. There is Sunday, but...
Hey, have you seen Kenton?
Oh, hi, Adam.
He's getting quite a few stares, although not all for the right reasons.
How are you getting on? Are you looking a bit lonely?
No. We're fine. We're just making sure we don't lose the booth.
Well, we're here now if you want to go and dance. Look, Kenton could probably do with some supervision.
Yeah, I'm sure he doesn't need us.
No. Come on.
What? Well, if he's really that drunk, we should go and help him out, should we know?
Oh! Yes. Well, maybe we should.
Go on. Good man. Ian.
What? Do you not think they make the perfect threesome?
You're not lying to me, Tom.
No, Helen.
Both their phones just keep going to voicemail.
Look, I'm not saying Rob and Ian are acting like bosom buddies.
But nothing terrible's happened.
No.
Oh, good. I might be able to sleep now. And everything's definitely all right. It's just you don't sound like you're having fun.
I'm fine.
Tom?
Look, just go back to bed.
Not until you tell me what's wrong.
It's nothing. It's just... after the argument with Dad and the cows...
Oh, you shouldn't be worrying about that.
How can I not? And then with the house and the wedding...
I know. It's a lot of stress.
But that stuff should be making me happy, shouldn't it?
And you are happy. Come on, Tom, of course you are.
I don't know.
What are you trying to say?
I don't know, Helen. It's just... all the stuff I've been working for. The business, a home, a family. It's all I've ever wanted since...
Is this to do with Brenda?
Huh?
Seeing her again. I mean, it must have been a bit strange.
I guess. I'm not sure. I mean, she's obviously doing a lot better without me, but
so
maybe...
what? You saying Kirsty's not the right person? Look, Tom, it's probably just nerves. Everyone gets them.
Yeah.
This brings it all back.
I can see. No more aches and pains then?
Nope.
Not now you've had your revenge.
Oh, come on. If anything, Rob should be flattered all the attention he's been getting.
Not quite what he was hoping for.
Yeah, well, you can always ask Helen for a private dance, Candy.
Ah, speaking of which, do you think it's time we went back to the hotel?
Yeah, might be.
There you two are! Right.
Hey, Tom, enjoying yourself?
You're not having second thoughts.
Second thoughts?
We haven't lured you over to the other side, have we?
No. Although, I do think I'm about done.
Yeah. Yeah, we were just saying. We thought we'd head off.
Fair dues.
So, where are the others?
No idea.
Yeah, well, I suppose they must be off having fun together.
Oh, well, I'm sure they can look after themselves.
Yeah. Go on, then. We'll catch them over for breakfast.
That's it, Hinton. Didn't you go, pal?
I know.
Where are we?
We're getting him.
Now, there was a problem with the minibus, so we're taking the train instead.
See, it's morning. You just sit tight.
We're going to find the others on the platform.
Right?
Fine.
Good lad.
Now, you just close your eyes. It's going to be quite a long journey.
Aye. Sit back and enjoy the ride.
Poor Kenton. I do feel a bit sorry for him.
Do you?
Yeah. Moving on a stag night and not drinking can't be much fun. Unless, of course...
what?
Well, willpower is not exactly Kenton's strongest point.
Then he'll have me to answer to. Mm. I ain't touched chocolate while he's been off gallivanting.
Yeah, fair enough.
And besides, they need someone sober enough to get them on the minibus.
Mm-hmm.
I told him, back by 10, because we're interviewing new bar people.
Oh, it's all right, Mum. You can say. You're interviewing for someone to replace Reese.
Oh, I'm sorry, darling.
So that's today, is it?
Yeah, we've got a couple of candidates coming in this morning.
Oh, right. Well, I hope they come up to scratch. I better make tracks.
Oh, and you gonna have any breakfast?
No, I'll grab something at work. Oh, and I'm going to go straight on to Kirsty's hen party.
Oh, right.
So don't expect me back until late.
I'll leave the bolt off. Have a great time.
Yeah, will do.
Oh. Hello, the bolt.
Jolene, it's me.
Kenton, we were just talking about you. Tell me you're on your way home.
Not quite. I'm not even in Birmingham. I'm in McCunliffe.
Where?
McCunliffe. It's somewhere near Aberystwyth, as far as I can make out.
But how did you get there?
I don't know. I woke up on a train.
What?
Everything here's written in Welsh. I thought it was my eyesight at first.
But how did you end up on a train, huh?
Look, never mind about that now. The next service back to Birmingham is in an hour, and that won't get in till 12:30. Oh. And then I've got to change for Felpersham and then Hollerton Junction.
Kenton.
So God knows when I'm actually going to get home.
Kenton.
And meanwhile, there's this old lady on the platform keeps muttering at me. I haven't a clue what she's saying.
Kenton, just tell me the truth. Have you been drinking?
Happy?
Are you serious? I honestly thought I was going to end up staggering around town with L plates on my back.
As if we would.
Well, let's not make any promises. The night's only just started.
No, the room's ours for the entire evening.
There is one thing, though. Helen, in the bag.
Oh, yeah. Oh, here it comes.
Well, so you wanted to know what I brought.
Oh, yes! Well, you won't wear a tiara for the actual wedding.
Come on, put it on.
Oh, must I?
Yes, sir.
You look like one of Abby's princess dolls.
Oh, thanks a lot, Hayley.
Very fancy. I just like this place. Have you seen the menus?
I know.
We're so much more sophisticated than the boys.
Oh, that's a point. Anyone know how it went?
What, last night?
Yeah, all I could get from Tom was a request for more paracetamol.
I reckon he must have enjoyed himself.
Oh, why? What's Roy said?
Nothing. That's what I mean. His lips were sealed.
Well, Helen?
No.
I don't know anything.
What, Rob hasn't given you any clues?
Rob? No.
They're managing to keep it all very secret.
Don't worry. We'll get it out of them. Just as soon as we withdraw their privileges.
Hayley, you don't.
What? You've got to train them somehow.
So where are Alice and Anya?
Cash point. They'll be here in a minute.
All right.
Well, I'm not sure I need to know that much. Tom came back with both his eyebrows. That's the most important
true.
Thing. I left him curled up on the sofa.
Same here with Roy.
Yeah, I suspect poor Henry will find himself put to bed early. Well, look, never mind about them. It's supposed to be a hen night, isn't it? Mm. Look, glasses everywhere. Oh. To sisters, doing it for themselves.
Oh.
Kenton, light of my life, I brought you some supper.
Oh,
sorry, I didn't wake you, did I?
No, not really. Oh, Jolene, not so close.
Oh, didn't it smell good? I thought you could do with something nice and hearty, so I made you some oxtail soup.
Great.
Do you still need the bucket?
Yes, please, just leave it.
Oh, okay.
And put the soup on the side, I'll have it in a bit.
You really have made yourself poorly, haven't you?
Oh, wasn't my fault.
Oh, of course it weren't.
Oh, they tricked me, Jolene. I thought it was mineral water.
Oh, and them nasty boys. They kept on tricking you, didn't they? Until they tricked you so much you couldn't remember being put on a train.
Well, no, but...
Here, have a spoonful.
It's just that after one sip, I thought I might as well carry on.
I see.
Jolene.
Open wide.
That's delicious.
Is it? Mm. Well, you've had one spoonful now. You might as well finish the bowl.
But it was so much harder for you, Hayley. I mean,
How long was Abby in an incubator?
3 weeks. It seemed like forever, though. Sorry, Kirsty.
Oh, no.
We're not trying to scare you.
Honestly, it's fine.
Does anyone want to finish this wine?
Not for me, Fallon.
Oh, you sure?
Yeah.
I might have some more coffee.
Oh, okay, then.
That first time you hold him in your arms, though. Oh, everything else, the last 9 months, the pain of labour. I mean, it just evaporates.
I'm not so sure about that. My coccyx still isn't right.
Really?
See what you've got to look forward to.
Oh, I know, but I still can't wait. I reckon Tom's going to be a brilliant dad. Mm. Don't you, Helen?
Me? What the best person to ask. But I remember what he was like as a little brother.
So, what are we going to do now?
Now?
Going home, surely. It's already past my bedtime.
Oh, come on. We've got to have more fun than this.
We are having fun.
Let's go to a club.
A club?
Yes.
Fallon, it's Thursday night. Nowhere will be open.
No, there's Tropics.
What? You are not serious.
Yeah. We're teenagers and dirty old men.
Yeah. Been there since I was a teenager.
Exactly. For old time's sake. Come on, it'll be a laugh.
Oh, well,
one last big blowout. Don't you want to give the boys a run for their money?
No, I can't.
You have to.
We're dead, you know.
Oh, but...
Just one phone number.
Oh, and I can ask anyone.
Anyone at all.
How about the guy down there on his own next to that couple snogging?
Oh, no.
He'd be so flattered. He'll probably give you his pin number too.
Oh, that's cruel. Do I have to?
Yes.
It's gone.
We've made it easy for you now. Come on.
Get down those stairs.
Anyone for another drink?
What?
Drink my round. What are you having?
Hello, I'm all right. I've still got this one.
Helen, quick, she's actually doing it.
Oh, she means business as well. Look at that wall. Go, get him.
Fallon, you're watching this.
Fallon.
I don't believe it.
What?
Lying.
Cheating.
Oh, Fallon, hold on.
Where's she going?
She's gone to find the others.
I don't think so. Oh, no.
What? Look where she's heading. Over there with the girl doing the Miley Cyrus impression.
Oh,
it's Reese, isn't it? Oh, yeah. No, it's definitely Reese.
Blimey, she's furious.
Can you blame her? They only split up a few weeks ago and he told her it's because he was moving away.
Oh, what was that?
I think she just slapped
him. Oh, no, we better go and do something. I'll go.
Yeah, before she tears that girl's pigtails off. Oh, Helen, hurry! Oh, the bouncers are dragging her out!
No!
No!
Get
off me! Time to go home, look.
But you can't do this! I manage a bar, I know my rights.
Excuse me, Fallon.
You have to let me back in.
Fallon, come on now.
Yeah, he has to let me back in. I pay £5 to get into the sleeper.
I know, but we have to.
Are you going to give me my money back?
Just calm down.
Hello, is there a problem here?
No.
Yes,
no.
Good, the police. Because that man has robbed me.
Fallon.
He's a thief.
I'm so sorry. She said one too many fruit ciders.
Don't I know you?
Me?
Yes. You're from Ambridge.
Well, how do you know that?
He's our neighbourhood officer, PC Burns.
Well remembered.
Oh, right. He's the one that you all reckon is really fit.
Yes, thank you.
So are you going to do your job or what?
Fallon! She's not normally like this. I'm sorry. I'm going to put her in a cab and...
I think that's for the best.
Right, come on.
Yeah, but...
We're going to the taxi rank.
Where? No.
Look, let's not waste police time.
But why am I the one that gets chucked out? Hey! Hey, how come you're not chucking him out? It's Reese. Is he the one?
I know, it's unfair.
Bring him out here! Go on!
Fallon!
I'll show you! I'll find him!
What are you doing?
Arrest the right person!
I'm going to need you to calm down.
Fallon!
Calm down! Am I safe to come in? I'm not going to have to restrain you again.
You didn't have to restrain me before.
Really? Well, I could go back to Tropics and ask them for their CCTV. Of course, it'd mean spending another couple of hours in the cells, but if that's what you prefer...
I prefer not to be here. Haven't you got real criminals to catch?
What can I say? It's been a quiet night. And you, Miss Fallon Rogers of the Bull in Ambridge, yeah?
Yes.
You're about the liveliest thing that's happened all evening.
So what, you just go around picking up innocent women off the streets?
When they throw themselves at me, I do.
Yeah, right, you like that.
You know I could charge you with assaulting a constable in the execution of his duty.
Knock yourself out.
But how about you tell me what got you so upset?
Look, I just wanted to get back in the club.
For what reason?
My ex-boyfriend, he was in there.
X.
What, are you writing all this down, or are you?
And I understand there was another woman involved.
Yes. Maybe, I don't know. Well, the only reason we split up was because he said he was moving for work. It's not like we were rowing or anything.
Oh, so you didn't want to?
No, I just thought it might take him a little longer to get over it.
I see. Well, I don't think we need to take this any further.
No?
No. Sounds to me like this ex-boyfriend of yours probably deserved what was coming to him.
Well, thank you.
You're free to go, miss.
Oh, there you are. Is that it?
Yes, that's it.
There's no follow-up?
Shouldn't have been here in the first place.
Well, I've given her a caution. So if this happens again, we might be forced to hang on to it for a little while longer.
Yeah, you wish.
One word of advice, though, before you go to bed. Drink plenty of water for the hangover. It always does the trick for me.
Cheers. I'll remember that.
Fallon, did I sense a bit of...
What?
Between you and him?
No! Well, that's square.
Okay, okay.
Oh, gosh, I don't know what you lot see in him.
Fine. Let's just get out of here.
Oh, hang on, where's my purse?
Oh, I don't know. Did you bring it with you?
I don't think so. Oh, man, I must have left it in the club. We'll have to go back.
No, we can't.
Helen, it's got my keys
it's
in it.
It's gone too. It'll be closed by now.
Oh, great.
Look, never mind.
I'll have to call Mum, I suppose.
No, no, best not to wake her.
But
why don't you just come back to ours instead?
Yeah, I guess. What a brilliant night this has turned out to be.
Ruth, you're up.
Morning.
Did you sleep well?
I'll tell you in a bit. Have the boys gone to school?
Yep. I packed them off about 15 minutes ago.
Really? Wow, I didn't hear a thing.
Good. They made sure to be quiet.
Did they?
They know how important it is you get your rest. Coffee? I'm making one for Eddie.
No, thanks.
Breakfast, then. Come on, sit down. I could do you porridge or bacon and eggs.
Actually, Jill, I'm not really that hungry.
Aren't you feeling well, Ruth?
No, I'm fine. I just don't think I've quite woken up yet.
You look pale. Remember, I bought you those supplements. They're in the cupboard.
I know.
We need to keep you healthy.
And Mum said exactly the same thing to me last night. I'll have something in a while.
Okay, just let me know.
Thanks.
It's a lovely day. Have you seen?
Mm.
Finally, a bit of sun. It makes such a difference. And the catkins have started coming out on the pussy willow.
Oh, so they have.
It might even be warm enough for the bees to be out. I thought I might check on them later.
That sounds like a nice thing to do.
It does, doesn't it? You could join me if you like.
Oh, honestly, you're welcome to stay, Fallon.
No, no.
Isn't she, Rob?
Well.
Really, Helen, I'm better off in my own bed.
Yeah, nothing worse than feeling rotten in company.
No.
Well, only if you're sure. Don't walk home, though. Rob can give you a lift. You're just about to leave for work, aren't you?
Yeah, I suppose.
No, I'll walk. I could do with the fresh air.
Oh, okay.
But thanks for letting me sleep over, though. I'm not quite sure what I would have done without you.
Don't be daft. Couldn't leave you sitting on the front step of the ball.
Well, no. Well, last night, I didn't exactly cover myself with glory. Let's just sweep it under the carpet.
Yeah, fine by me.
Thanks. Well, bye then. I'm sorry for hogging the bathroom, Rob.
Oh, no problem.
Oh, bye, Fallon. Take care.
Okay.
Bye. Oh, I hope she's going to be okay.
She's not dying, Helen. She's got a hangover.
No, I know. But it's horrible feeling rough like that.
So, come on then. You're going to tell me what happened?
It's probably not worth going into.
Well, I'd still like to know.
Oh, would you now?
Yes.
Are you going to tell me what happened on Tom's stag? Right, look, I'll do you a deal. I'll tell you my secrets if you tell me yours.
Helen.
What?
Nobody from the stag ended up passed out on our sofa. Well, did they?
All right. Fallon saw Reese dancing with another girl and she got a bit leery.
What was Reese doing there?
Well, we were in a club. Look, I didn't even want to go, but Fallon was determined.
What club?
Tropics in town.
Where's that?
Oh, it's near the Drill Hall on Wellbourne Street. The point is, Fallon made a bit of a scene and ended up being taken away by the police.
She was arrested?
Yeah, they let her off with a caution. She just had a bit too much to drink. Please, Rob, don't say anything. You could see how embarrassed she was.
Yeah, I'm not surprised.
I mean, it's not exactly the end of the night I wanted either. I had to abandon poor Kirsty and go to the station. But fortunately, it was that policeman who came to the WI that was dealing with it.
Really? And that's all?
Why? What else do you think there is?
Well, I don't know. I'm just curious. Judging by the state of Fallon, you obviously all went for it last night.
Oh, not really.
So what sort of place is Tropics, anyway?
It's just a club. It's pretty grotty.
So why did you go?
I just told you. I'll take you there if you like. You'll loathe it.
No, thanks.
All right, then. Now, since I've been so candid, why don't you give me a little something?
Actually,
how did you get on with Ian?
No, I have to go. I'm already running late. I'll see you this evening.
Hey, hang on.
Sorry.
Where are you going? Not fair, mister.
Come on, please. You must be up by now.
Wow. Someone had a good night.
Oh, Tom.
Kirsty was home by 12:30. Where did you end up?
Nowhere. No, I just stayed over with Helen.
And you didn't think to take a change of clothes?
It wasn't exactly planned.
Well, I suppose I shouldn't pry. At least you didn't wake up in deepest, darkest Wales. Perhaps Kenton's still there.
No, I know he got back. Mum should be home. Just want to sleep. I'm working from 2 until close. I'm the same again tomorrow.
Oh, dear.
Plus the clocks are going forward.
Ooh. Well, you are the boss. If you need to pull a sickie, it's not as if anyone's going to find out.
Yeah, right. Let me in!
Fallon.
What? Oh, you're kidding.
I hope I'm not going to have to charge you with breaking and entering.
No, of course not, officer.
Because if you are, I might be able to help.
Oh, you reckon?
Your purse. You must have dropped it in the car last night.
Oh, did I? Right.
You're lucky it wasn't stolen. We get a lot of criminals in the back of this thing.
Yeah, well, thanks. That's really good of you.
Anytime. Rescuing damsels in distress, it's one of the perks of the job. Take her now.
Fallon?
Yeah, just don't say anything.
Look, I know I wasn't going to pry,
yeah, then
but...
don't.
Oh, come on.
It was just a misunderstanding.
One that landed you in the back of a police car?
Yeah, it's over now. I've got my keys.
Was Kirsty there? I knew she was hiding something when she got in. What happened? Fallon?
Huh? Nothing.
What's that in your purse? Let's see.
Tom, it's only a business card.
Then give us a look. In case of emergency, call any time. PC Harrison Burns.
If that's ever going to happen. What?
Well, don't take it out on me. You're the one being pursued by the police.
There, Ruth. Put that on. And here's a cup of tea.
Oh, Jill, you're an angel.
You sure you wouldn't rather be inside, though, if you're feeling cold?
No, a jumper will do the trick. I'm enjoying the sunshine.
It is gorgeous. Now, let's see. How are we doing?
Is there anything I can do to help? I could hold the smoker for you.
No, you sit there, darling. I can manage.
Any signs of Aurora?
There doesn't seem to be. By the looks of it, all the hives have survived the winter.
That's excellent.
Yes. Oh, goodness me. The feeder's almost empty.
It's going to be interesting to see how this neonic span works out.
Well, I know it hasn't helped you.
Not particularly.
And to be honest, the oilseed rape was good for my bees. It tided them over whilst there wasn't much else in flower.
We've only halved the acreage.
Yeah, I know. Ruth, could you pass me the syrup? It's by your feet.
Sure. Although if we do see our yields go down drastically, we might be forced to turn the whole lot over to other crops.
Oh. You okay, love?
Fine.
Thanks.
That's the trouble with having to go back to these older pesticides. They're just not as effective.
Plus the harm the other insects that eat the aphids and the beetles.
Well, it is only for 2 years.
Yeah, I know.
And something has to be done if the ban does prove these chemicals have been killing bees.
Well, we'll see what happens. It's all swings and roundabouts.
No, that's very true. About the only thing that stayed constant on the farm are my hives. It's probably why I love them so much.
That and your delicious honey.
Yes. Well, they've served me very well over the years. I think I probably liked it because it was something just for me. I was such a fish out of water when I first came to Brookfield. Keeping bees was my own little contribution.
Yeah.
My own herd in miniature. You never know. One day it might be Pip sitting where you are, and you'll be the one tending to the bees.
I'd like that.
Oh. Ruth?
Oh, I'm sorry, Jill.
What's the matter?
I think I need to go and lie down.
You in pain?
Oh, I'll be all right. You carry on.
Oh. It's a bit ridiculous. Let me help you inside.
Oh. I knew there was something going on. So is Fallon going to call him?
Oh, I don't think so. The car's probably already in the bin.
Oh, shame. If she wants to get over Reese, a hunky policeman wouldn't be a bad place to start.
There. That's the planter all hitched up. Now we just need the driver to get off the phone.
Is that what you're up to today, planting potatoes?
Oh, I'm helping out as and when. Really, I'm just trying to smooth things over with Dad.
Yeah, sure.
I've decided to tell Animal Health.
Oh, about...
the broken fence incident, yeah. I had time to think about it last night. I mean, just imagine if TB does crop up in the pigs, and it comes out, I knew there'd been contact with Dad's cows all along. It's not going to look very good for the brand.
No.
Even though I'm trying to bury the thought at the back of my mind somewhere. Hope for the best, prepare for the worst. Isn't that what they say?
Well, quite.
It ought to be the family motto. You couldn't just tug the hydraulic line out of the way?
Yep.
Thanks.
Tom, about your stag night. When we spoke on the phone...
Forget it. I was in a really funny place.
No, but...
I started the evening in a bad mood, and then... what with all the drinking and the forced hilarity...
You sounded pretty serious.
Did I?
Just a bit. I spent all last night thinking you were about to call off the wedding. Listening to poor Kirsty rhapsodising about how happy she is to be marrying you.
Why? What did she say?
Never you mind. So... definitely not having second thoughts.
No. Honestly, it was just pre-wedding jitters, like you said. I let things get on top of me. I'm feeling much better now.
Oh, good. There's been enough drama in my love life without you getting in on the act as well.
Believe me, Helen, if there's one thing I'm certain about, it's that I want to marry Kirsty. Don't worry. I'm absolutely fine.
Ruth, you're right in there. Ruth! Oh, I was worried you'd fainted.
No.
Ruth, what's the matter? Should I call the doctor? You're as wet as a sheet.
Jill.
Where's the phone?
No.
Ruth, you're not well. You need to see someone. Let me just fetch the phone.
It's too late. I know it is. There was too much blood.
What? Oh. Oh, no.
Jill.
Oh, my darling. Oh.
I think I've lost the baby.